Axis of evil.
A year ago, George W. Bush branded six countries as the world's most evil. I wanted to explore the enemy territory. So I took a holiday through the Axis of Evil. This is the last and oldest Cold War front line in the world. It's the absurdly named Demilitarized Zone, one of the most heavily armed places on Earth.
Checkpoint Bravo's manned 24 hours a day and regulates all traffic in and out of the Demilitarized Zone.
We took a tour from the south. We had an American GI as our guide. This is the line that has divided Korea since the end of World War II, when Russia occupied the north, America the south. Both countries then put puppet regimes in power. In 1950, after numerous incursions by both sides, North Korea invaded the South. The ensuing Korean War lasted 3 years and cost 2 million lives. No peace treaty was ever signed, and technically the two sides are still at war.
When you read articles about this place, you're told that the tension is palpable, and I thought that was just writers trying to sound like tough guys, but we're being watched by at least two North Korean soldiers now. And you can, really, feel the tension. And the Americans have had some of their fellow soldiers killed, they've had soldiers killed, so you get the impression that all of them are just itching to have a go at the others.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to United Nations Command Checkpoint 3. On this ridge line, that's the northern boundary of the DMZ, which is approximately 2,000 meters from where you're standing at right now. Over here on the left-hand side of the tree line, you'll see what looks like some large white letters. Okay, that's actually a North Korean propaganda sign. Once translated from Hangul to English, it roughly states, our general is the best general. Now, if you look straight out from that, that's another Korean sign, and roughly that one says, Yankee, go home.
In about 4 or 5 days, we're going to do the tour of North Korea to find out what life is really like in there, and then we're going to film what they present to us as life in North Korea, which is very different, I think.
They think that BMW is manufactured by North Korea. They think that BMW is actually manufactured in North Korea. There's a lot of things that they have no clue. See that radio tower?
Yeah.
That's the city of Kaesong. And those radio towers, you can see three more over there, they're actually jammers to block all of our transmissions, our radio and our television transmissions, so that they have no idea of what actually goes on in the outside world. So I'm sure when you get there, you're going to see a big difference in things going on. Kind of like Hitler burning the books.
Any message for the North?
No.
There have been plenty of skirmishes along this line. The most famous was in 1976, when American soldiers used an axe to chop down a tree that was obscuring their vision. North Korean soldiers approached, a fight broke out, and two Americans were killed by the very same axe they were using to chop the tree.
Here, this man's, he's kind of hard to see, but he's actually fighting off seven North Korean soldiers. This is the helmet of Captain Arthur Boniface, who was killed in front of his own vehicle. And here you can clearly see a North Korean soldier wielding an axe at 1st Lieutenant Mark Barrett, who was later killed.
My journey into North Korea was going to be controlled by government-appointed minders who would not allow me to meet any ordinary North Koreans. So I travelled to Seoul to meet defectors who had completed the long and hazardous journey to the south. At least 250,000 have fled across the Chinese border. Only the lucky few make it to the south, where they are finally given refugee status.
There's a couple of North Korean refugees here who will talk to us but don't want to appear in front of camera. I don't know if they're worried about their own safety or the safety of their families back in North Korea. It seems there are very few entire families escaped. And even when families have escaped, their distant family members like cousins back at home, even they can be arrested and sent to prison for a short sentence in prison is 10 years. And the prison camps sound brutal. There's hardly any food, forced labour, and public executions regularly. I think there's about 200,000 prisoners in the northeast of North Korea at the minute.
This would be the only time during my trip I could talk openly to North Koreans.
I'm just trying to get a sense of what daily life is like there, you know, what the hardships, what the dangers.
They educate you from the moment you're born.
The moment a child utters a word, they start him on ideological training, making him say, "Thank you, dear leader," and "Thank you, great leader," all the time. So they can't think for themselves.
In the mid-1990s, a tragic mixture of natural disaster and state failure led to a famine that killed between 1 and 3 million people.
North Korea is a country where people die of starvation. Can you imagine that? People say, "May the great leader live 10,000 years." Even those dying of starvation say it. When you go to North Korea, you'll only get to meet those saying, "Long live the great leader, Father General." However, everywhere you cannot look would be full of corpses. North Korea is a society where human bodies are stacked up like firewood.
I couldn't think because of the brainwashing. I believe that the hunger resulted from the American economic sanctions, as I'd been told.
I was traveling with Will, my producer, armed only with a small camera. We had been told to expect heavy questioning, and possibly even a strip search upon arrival in North Korea.
Korea guidebook, which includes a big section on South Korea. Can I take that?
You underlined anything? Or...
Yeah, I've highlighted stuff. But they've mentioned the famine here, and I'm not sure we can mention the famine to our guides. And certainly it's got pictures of South Korea in it, which could be seen as very dangerous because they show a quite successful, well-fed South Korea. Like marketplaces full of food. That's probably not a good picture to show North Koreans.
Enough journalists have got in before posing as tourists with tourist cameras.
Yeah, and some journalists have even said that it's a little cat and mouse game where they kind of know you're a journalist. It's just a case of them letting you take pictures of what they want and you trying to get pictures of what you want.
I left the bustling and prosperous streets of South Korea, expecting a grim-faced and hostile reception.
Can I have a welcome to?
What do you say?
Welcome to Korea. Welcome to Korea. Yeah.
Thank you.
Nice.
Our two guides were Mr. Park and Miss Park, no relation. They would accompany us in our every waking hour for the next 7 days.
Mr. Lee, Jong Park, Mr. Lee.
Mr. Lee.
In just one line of his Axis of Evil speech, George Bush condemned North Korea as a regime arming itself with missiles and weapons of mass destruction while starving its citizens. Last year, only 150 Western tourists came here. With no internet, mobile phones, and only state-run media, North Korea has rightly been described as the Hermit Kingdom.
Well, the first thing you notice is just how quiet it is everywhere. I mean, there's literally, I don't know, 10 cars. I mean, I'm looking over half the city and I can probably see 10 cars. In addition to that, along the riverbank, I can see at least 50 or 60 people fishing. And even on the very carefully controlled and mapped out drive from the airport to the hotel, which took us past all the great and huge monuments and landmarks, we saw dozens and dozens of people fishing. And quite a few people just crouched down going through the grass, presumably looking for bits of grain or rice or, I don't know, any scraps of food. I'm saying I'm not paranoid and I'm relaxing, but I haven't managed to break out of a whisper yet in my own hotel room. So I don't think that's quite true. We've been told by quite a few people, most people we've asked actually, that it's not safe to talk in the hotel room because they're bugged. Good. No two-way mirror. The highlights of their room include an empty fridge, and TV, which has got one channel. Had one channel.
North Korea is desperate to engage with the outside world, and it soon became clear that our tour was going to be one long advert for North Korea and its heroic soldiers, factory workers, farmers, and intellectuals. I was taken to the statue of North Korea's president, officially called Great Leader Comrade Kim Il-sung. And for a few US dollars, was told to lay flowers at his feet.
Oh, Mr. William, don't forget to take the full picture of the statue, okay? Don't cut in half. This is the most sacred place. Yes?
The great leader ruled from 1948 until his death in 1994, and over $2.5 billion was spent on ceremonies and monuments in his memory. He holds the office of president eternally, making North Korea the only country in the world with a dead president.
Is Kim Il-sung just a human being or more, greater?
Of course, he is a human being, but he is highly what?
Developed?
Yes, I think. That means he is not God, but I think he's very hardworking for the people and he do everything for the people.
And the people are still working hard for him. An army of volunteers keeps his statue spotlessly clean. And when a bird threatens to blemish the great leader, there is panic down below, until the bird is finally chased away. After 3 years of official mourning for the great leader, his son, Kim Jong-il, was declared the country's dear leader, creating communism's only ever dynasty.
Kim Il-sung was called the great leader.
Yes.
And Kim Jong-il was called the dear leader.
Yes.
Right. Does that mean he is less than his father?
No, not that it not
just
mean.
Different.
Yes.
The Victorious Fatherland Liberation War Museum was the first of many I would be taken to. Here I would learn that the great leader single-handedly defeated Japanese imperialism in 1945. With no mention of World War II.
This picture shows the invincibility of Korean people united strongly around the great leader, Generalissimo Kim Il-sung, who defeated to imperialism US and Japan.
In 1950, after finally getting support and permission from Russia and China, General Kim Il-sung invaded the South in an attempt to reunify Korea.
In this room and next room, you can see how the U.S. aggressors occupied South Korea and prepared the aggressive war against the northern half of the Republic.
If the attack came from the South first,
How
come the North made so much progress into the South?
Oh, I will explain later.
Okay. What were the Russians and Chinese doing in North Korea?
I will explain
later.
What do you make of it all?
Oh, well, every time I ask a fairly obvious question, we're told we haven't got time, we'll talk about it later on.
These are captured American soldiers. Captured guns.
From?
The U.S. armies. How can you express this was captured weapons?
Yeah.
In other words.
No, that's right. Captured weapons.
Captured weapons is right.
Yeah.
Yeah. And this was from British armored car. Yeah.
And what biological weapons did they use?
So many insects. So many biological weapons.
They dropped insects that had diseases in them.
Insects, yeah. So many insects. Flies, grasshoppers, and
And they captured them and dropped them on North Korea?
They dropped all these insects in the land on the land of North Korea.
The showpiece of the museum is a huge revolving panoramic painting of a famous battle. The unshaven alcoholics are the US imperialist aggressors. The suntanned heroes with white teeth, the North Korean army.
These are captured American soldiers.
The great leader himself came here 15 times, and each time declared it a masterpiece and a national treasure.
In this battle, we killed and captured 24,000 American soldiers.
This is the USS Pueblo, which is the only US naval vessel in captivity in the world. So proudly kept open for us a little bit later than normal.
The USS Pueblo is North Korea's greatest trophy, and it's moored permanently in the country's capital.
Okay.
He's a veteran who played a part in the battle to capture USS Pueblo.
After a gunfight, the crew were captured. One sailor was killed.
The American soldier was killed here?
Yes, here.
The crew were only released 11 months later, after the US government wrote a grovelling apology.
Can I just read this?
Yes, yes.
The government of the United States of America shoulders full responsibility and solemnly apologizes for the grave acts of espionage committed by the US ship against the Democratic People's Republic of Korea. It's nice to see something where both sides agree.
Yes.
This is the first time.
Our 7 men boarded the Pueblo and captured 83 of the armed villains. If American imperialists infiltrate this land again, we'll chase them to the end of the world and bomb their bases. We'll crush them mercilessly under our feet.
What does he think of Bush?
He's a war fanatic and a warmonger.
I'm glad to visit this spy ship of the US for the third time. This spy ship will remain vivid in the mind of all visitors on the shameful spying activities of the US. Keep this spy ship on exhibition forever. Someone from Mauritius. I can't think of anything funny to write.
Fairly neutral, I'd suggest. No pressure.
I can't win because they're watching and you're taping. I can't win. Fascinating glimpse.
Yes.
Into a very dramatic incident.
Yes.
The guide was very helpful. An eyewitness. Finally, an incident both sides agree on. There is hope. Understand?
Yes.
Is this Korean food?
I am very thirsty.
Chicken as well? No.
Pork.
No, we're getting offered the best food available. And it's literally the pork is tiny lumps of gristle and fat. So goodness knows what they're getting when they go home. The chicken's okay, but again, what part of the chicken is that?
So where do you live? You live in near here?
This is a middle district, and I live here, just beside the river.
So you live with your family?
Yes.
Yeah.
Mother-in-law and father-in-law and my husband and one daughter. Her name is Ji-yeon, meaning the pond of knowledge, the lake of knowledge, yes.
Is she only 1 year old?
Yes.
People here like American music?
I just forgot the name, the famous singer. It starts from E.
A man or a woman?
Man.
E. Elvis.
Elvis, yes.
Elvis.
Yes.
He's your favorite.
I don't know him.
Well, I kind of came here. I'd read all the articles, I'd read all the books. I was coming here ready to sort of laugh at the personality cult here and, you know, the ridiculousness of it all. And I came here actually thinking that by the end of the week I'd confront our guides and say, look, what you're showing me is a sham. But, I don't know, they're breaking my heart.
The next day, we were driven for 3 hours to visit what we were told was a typical cooperative farm. This vision of agricultural perfection did not tally with what I had read about the Great Famine.
Many people are dying from starvation.
I don't think it's so serious. It's not that serious.
Really?
Yes. Yes.
Because we read that many, many people starved.
There is still lack of foods, but not that kind of serious problem. Many people dying. So.
Are we wrong? Because we in our newspapers it said that maybe 1 million people died from starvation.
Maybe it will be propagandized.
Yeah?
I think it's a propaganda.
Not today, but in 97, 98, they said that as many as 1 million people were dying through starvation.
So I said it's maybe a propagandized.
Propaganda. The response I got every time I suggested there might be a few cracks in the great leader's sunshine state. It seemed pointless to mention the fact that many aid agencies think the number of deaths from famine could be as high as 3 million.
Let's go inside.
If millions have died through starvation, loyalty to the great and dear leaders remains unbreakable. Everywhere you go in North Korea, you see evidence of a country constantly prepared for war. 1 in 10 North Koreans wears military uniform, and you often see army trucks carrying soldiers and weapons.
What was in there?
Beef. lots of boxes of shells and machine guns.
Beef.
The beef will go off.
That was a lorry full of beef.
Yeah, beef, yeah. Beef. Right.
Beef can mean trouble. Like, if I have beef with you, yeah, it means I have a problem with you.
So America has a beef with North Korea, you could say.
Lots of that, I think, the nuclear beef they have.
Just entering the demilitarized zone from the north. We just walked under a tank block, which can be dropped onto the road to block American tanks coming through.
Yes.
Oh, Mr. Anderson. Mr. Ben Anderson.
Anderson?
Yes.
William.
William?
William Anderson.
Oh. And your name is there? Mr. Kim.
Mr. Kim.
Just 1 week later and I was back at the demilitarized zone. Only this time I was inside the Axis of Evil, looking out.
American soldiers, you. This place is very volatile.
In other places, you'd need a big incident to start war. But here, even the smallest mistake made by one soldier could lead to a war. During the Korean War, my whole family, 11 in total, were massacred. My father was the only survivor. Because of my family history, my father has been in uniform all his life, and his 5 sons are all serving on the front line.
American soldier.
I didn't dare tell him we'd been shown around by the very same American soldier just a week before.
In the newspapers, it said that they have an axe on display.
Oh, yeah.
What do they use to kill American soldiers in the 1960 or 1970?
Kill American soldiers?
True? Yeah, with an axe.
신문에서 나왔는데 미국 군사 군인들을 때린 그 도끼가 전시돼 있답니다.
거기 뭐 봤은가? 있어요. 아까 그 우리 들어가 봐서 사진들이랑 전시돼 있던 거기 그들이.
Okay, then we're gonna have to drop in there to see the axe.
Yeah.
Okay.
미안하지만 정근입니다. 이 정도 부재에서도 촬영할 수 있을까?
And in the darkest part of the museum, we found the axe, proudly displayed in a glass case.
그런데 미국은 남선에서 세계적 대화마을에서 남선에서 물려받아 하지 않았습니다. 남선에 남아있어 부실을 마련해야 됐습니다.
여기 영어하는 사람 같은데?
Smiling, waving North Korean soldiers.
Yes.
It's very different to how we are told in the West.
I had expected a hermetically sealed communist state to be cold, grey and heavily industrialised. So I was surprised to find an afternoon on the beach as part of our itinerary.
We're on the beach, but there's a kind of wooden fence and there's an electric fence to stop American espionage scuba divers from swimming in from ships and becoming spies in North Korea somehow. Tell me it's electric, I'm not sure I believe it. Mr. Park! I can touch it?
No.
You sure?
Yeah, you'll be gone down.
I don't believe you. I don't believe it's electric, but nothing, even normal electric doesn't work here. TV, lights in the museum don't work. So I don't believe they can power a fence 24 hours a day to stop scuba spies from getting in.
You want to risk it?
No, I'm not going to touch it just yet.
Wow!
Maybe that's why the fence is there. To keep people in. Not to keep others out.
It's difficult to tell because our two guys are hand-picked, aren't they? They obviously come from a pretty privileged background. They obviously had life as comfortable as anyone. So there wouldn't be any hint of dissent from them. But with more and more people crossing the border between China and North Korea, and with more information slowly coming in, the World Cup is on TV, people are listening to South Korean radio, some people have got satellite TV here. Maybe that's the sprout for a dissident movement that's going to lead somewhere. Who do you think might attack this country?
This country?
Yeah.
Americans. We think like that.
Attack?
Yeah, we think like that. If we have not enough the arms, then maybe it will be attacked by the Americans.
Yeah.
Because, you know, maybe it's happened in Iraq, and then Iraq today, and then the Afghanistan, the like. If we are not ready, of course, you see, for the attack, then maybe they can easily, of course, occupy this land.
Yeah.
It means, you know, we lost everything. Approximately 100 meters deep.
It's an air raid shelter.
Yes, yes.
Yes, too, yeah.
If there's another war, everyone would come down here to be safe.
That's right.
The obsession for war is everywhere. The metro stations are 100 metres deep, the roads are wide enough to double as runways, and there are tank traps everywhere. The Korean War ended almost 50 years ago, but it seems clear the North Koreans would fight to the death tomorrow.
If the US imperialist wants to fight, then we will fight. So we have to prepare.
Yeah.
But if they want to make up, if they want to talk peacefully, then we also want
That's good.
Yeah.
So you want peace?
She thought you laughed at her. She thought you laughed at her idea, and she got a bit upset for a little while. Then she says that all Westerners and tourists are the same. Whenever you mention peaceful reunification, they just laugh and they don't believe. All we believe is the propaganda we've been told.
This is for your fine art gallery, okay? Fine art here. The camera is not allowed. This is the great leader generalissimo Kim Il-sung and the great leader general Kim Jong-il. This is the great leader generalissimo Kim Il-sung during the anti-Japanese armed struggle period. The
generalism Kim Il-sung during the Korean War. This is
great. What's it saying? Let us reunify dragging the U.S. troops in South Korea. Let us reunify our country.
The gallery was dedicated to the deification of the great and dear leaders, celebration of the Korean War, and a few messages to America.
The modern art we just saw, to me, was propaganda.
This one?
Yeah.
But then, of course, the Koreans, anyhow, maybe not say this one is for propaganda. They say this one is for the promotion, of course, for the education of the people here.
But can't you criticize the society and still let society develop?
At this moment, of course, you see, they criticize at this moment. They criticize at this moment, yeah.
Not an air raid warning.
You have to run. Yeah, that's what okay. It sounds
like. It's an air raid siren.
Yeah, he's saying the same thing.
Oh, yeah. Mr. Bach, you have to get the permission.
Sorry?
Maybe they get angry.
Oh, whatever we feel.
Oh, yes. About people. Get the permission.
But to film?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
Is that all right?
Yeah, that's fine.
Looks like Americans.
Oh, so they think?
Oh, yes.
I could be American?
Yes.
You look like an American.
That's not good here, is it?
Bloody bad imperialist bastard.
Miss Park was faithfully towing the party line. However, a conversation about books showed that her world didn't revolve entirely around the great and dear leaders.
I like the books of the great leader and the dear leader.
Yeah.
And because it have a philosophy. And I also like the novels.
So which book is your favorite book of all time?
Maybe... Mostly I read the Jane Eyre.
Oh, really?
Yes.
I didn't know you had that here.
Yes.
Miss Park then took me to a bookshop, but we couldn't find any copies of Jane Eyre. Just books by or about the great and dear leaders, translated into every other language.
So which is the best book? The best Kim Il-sung book? For a beginner? This one?
Yes.
What's the best one as an introduction?
Memories.
Even Mr. Park was opening up.
This one is a bourgeois watch.
Bourgeois watch?
Bourgeois watch.
So how much?
Probably $1,000.
$14.
$14?
$14.
$14.
Yeah. How much was your watch?
$20.
$20?
Yeah, approximately.
You're so bourgeois. I'm proletariat.
Proletariat?
You're bourgeois with your $20 watch.
The most excessive display of nationalism is the Ararang Festival, where 100,000 performers praise the great and dear leaders and mourn the division of their country.
Thank you.
the south are shown as long-lost family members, with reunification blocked by the American military presence. While all the people of North and South live for reunification, I wondered if the dear leader felt the same way. He had to realise an open border and the information it would reveal would surely mean an end to his reign. On our last night, our guides finally agreed to join us for a meal.
We're happy to toast with the British bourgeoisie. Cheers.
We're caught in a trap. I can't walk out because I love you too much, baby.
You glad we're going?
How can you ask? In that way, I'm so sad. Really? Yes.
What you doing to me?
What have you enjoyed most this week?
This week? Every time when I was with you, I enjoyed very much. Yes, really. It's true.
Even when we argued about politics?
Oh, yes, of course. Because that is the stage we are getting close and we are getting understand. Yes, I think.
Mr. Park, you still think we're bourgeois?
Maybe you are turned into the revolutionary, I think. Socialist. From bourgeois.
When I go home, I'm going to give up all my luxurious goods.
Precisely, yes.
I'm a revolutionary, yes. So, yep. I think in politics, you never convert me.
I ask you, show just the feelings, you know, maybe to your friends, and then maybe to your parents, and then to your friends. And, you know, of course, for the promotion, of course, to bring the lot of, I think, the British people in. And then, you know, to see what's, I think, the so-called evils, the axis of evils looks like.
We still don't know whether or not you have nuclear weapons, nuclear beef.
Nuclear beef.
You think?
I'm just saying we don't know, you haven't got it, that's all.
Of course we have none. We have none.
Mr. Pat, I can't film in there. Say goodbye on camera.
Yeah, say goodbye.
Goodbye.
Predictably, I hadn't seen why North Korea should be included on George Bush's Axis of Evil list. But if my minders had given me a cosier impression of North Korea than it deserved, I was about to get a reminder of the North Korea I'd read about before my trip.
Psychological.
I met an American merchant sailor who'd been helping deliver food aid. He'd just spent 2 weeks in a prison camp for making a joke about the great leader.
Really believe this man is a freaking Jesus Christ himself.
So what was the joke?
The joke was, how come he's so fat? Everybody else so skinny. They just went berserk over that, man. I'm glad to be getting out of North Korea, man. That's a bad place. Communist dog, you quit. The United States and the world food better quit feeding the communist dog and starve him. That's the only thing that's going to make him understand. When his belly's hungry and he starts eating the bark off a tree.
We can't go on together with suspicious.
2 weeks after I left, the dear leader's officials confirmed America's suspicions. They announced that they are indeed actively pursuing a nuclear weapons program.
Axis of evil.